Welcome to the ePort Interactive Installation Guide. Before we get started, let's make sure you've got everything you need to complete the installation. You'll need the ePort Interactive device, a drill, a 1/4 inch to 1 3/8 inch step drill bit, a 1/4 inch metal drill bit, the interactive drilling template, hardware packet, marker, and level, the interactive LTE antenna and RF blocker clip, Phillips head screwdriver, a 1/4 inch nut driver, the deck splitter for the interactive unit, and the MDB cable with the ferret attachment for the interactive unit. To begin with, you may wish to tape a piece of paper to the front of the machine so that it is easier to spot where the marks are for drilling. Next, take the template and the level to find the right space for your interactive to be installed and level out the template. Now, take your marker and begin to fill in the spots where the holes are cut out on the template, taking note that the two circled areas are where you will use the 1/4 inch to 1 3/8 inch step down bit. Start with the 1/4 inch bit to drill guide holes and return to expand the holes to 1 3/8 inch and 1 half inch. Next, we'll begin installing the unit by threading the cable through the larger of the two holes, pulling them through to make sure that they do not get pinched behind the interactive unit, and then lining up the four screws to the holes on the machine and pressing it flush against the metal. Once it's done, check to make sure on the inside of the machine that the cable is pulled all the way through. Now, you'll use from the hardware packet the four nuts and the 1/4 inch nut driver to firmly affix the interactive unit to the machine. Make sure that when you're tightening it, you don't over-tighten, as we don't want to put undue stress on the unit itself. But it should be firmly against the machine so that it does not wiggle or move. Next, we'll want to install the MDB cable into the machine. First, make sure the machine is powered off, and then we'll find the MDB lead off of the board connecting to the bill acceptor. Disconnect that and install the MDB lead for the interactive unit in between. This puts the unit in first position, and it is where all ePort units should always be installed. Now we'll want to ground the unit using the ferrite loop and connecting it to a Phillips head screw close by to the MDB leads. Use the Phillips head screwdriver to unfasten the screw from the machine, being careful not to drop it after it's loose. Thread the screw through the ferrite loop and then reattach it firmly to the machine. Next, we'll want to connect the MDB lead to the interactive unit. In some instances, you may need to purchase an extension cable for the interactive unit so that the door can open all the way when a technician visits. As you'll see, this lead and the lead coming off of the unit itself are quite short, and on this type of machine, the door would not be allowed to swing open all the way once a technician arrives. They would instead need to power down and disconnect the unit before restocking the machine. The next lead off of the interactive unit is the DEX connection cable. We'll take the DEX cable for the interactive unit, connect the two plastic leads together, and then we'll connect the DEX cable into the machine. Here we'll connect the two plastic pieces together, and then we'll need to find the DEX harness off of the board. We'll need to disconnect any existing or installed DEX cable and install the DEX cable for the interactive in its place. We can use a secondary loop to reattach any other unit that's required to be connected to DEX. To install the antenna, look for a pre-drilled hole or drill your own hole with the 1/4 inch bit on top of the machine. Thread the wire to the inside, and then attach the RF blocker clip to the end of the cable. Plug the cable into the interactive unit and allow for the antenna cable to hang free and clear on the inside of the machine. We will now power on the machine and wait for the unit to come online. This might take a couple of minutes, especially if it is the first time that the unit is powering up, so be patient. As it's powering on, you will see that a USA Technologies logo does appear, and once it is fully initialized, it will go to the ready screen. If you'd like to check on the serial number, the signal strength, or the firmware revision, press the redeem button and enter 423-144-231 and press redeem. This is a diagnostic screen, and it will show you the serial number, the quality of cell signal, and the firmware revision on the device. Once you're done, press back and the back arrow, and you'll go to the ready screen. At this point, you'll want to do a test swipe to confirm that transactions will process. Once it's authorized, you can complete a vend or press the cancel button.